Bug concentrated on the storm. Whitecaps curled on the face of the bitter sea as furious jags of lightning slashed down from a darkened sky. Far off, the wobbling sails of ships leapt in the troughs of gray waves, struggling desperately against the winds that threatened to shear them into ragged scraps. Fishermen and frenzied shipmasters busied themselves along Krondor's docks as they raced to batten down flapping hatches and prevent unsecured goods from pitching into the churning seas. Everywhere there were planks and hammers and ropes, but among the workers not a soul dared utter a word. Wrongness. Pug sensed it as clearly as he smelled the salt in the air and felt the hardwood railing under his hand. What had begun 3 days ago as a seemingly weak summer squall was intensifying into a threshing eye of violence. Within hours, it would make landfall, doubtless bruising the livelihoods of many coastal towns, Krondor among them. Perhaps it can be tamed, Pug thought, his face twisting into a frown. More of a lesser path affair, but it should be simple enough. Even as he extended his hand from the image of another storm formed in his mind unbidden, a terrifying storm that had raged over his head as he came into the greatness of his power in a far distant empire called Suranwani. A storm that had tested his right to be a member of the alien assembly of magicians. A storm that had rent open the heavens and forever set him apart from other mortal men. Energy leapt from Pug's outstretched fingers into the heart of the storm, exploding within it a glorious rainbow pattern that illuminated the clouds in a throbbing elemental display. Greenish bands of color danced the sky as the wind began to abate, the torrential rains quickly softening to a mild patter as blue blasts of energy moved between sea and sky. Gently, the ocean stilled of its own accord. Satisfied the threat was reduced, Pug discontinued the spell with a slicing gesture and stepped back to watch the storm's progress. The sight eased his mind and allowed him time to mull over a series of issues, not the least of which was the ruined vacation that he, his wife Katala, and daughter Gamina had intended on making in Krondor, but like a lodestone to metal, he found his thoughts returning again and again to the recollections of the Empire. Arrayed in flame, the enemy comes, the shriek is cadence in skeleton drums.
For thunder's spite we rise our call, though down shall crumble empire all. A Surani poet, I believe he was House Omakan.
House Minwanabi, reign of the 53rd light of heaven. There's something you need to see me about, Makala. I am busy.
Busy? You've been behaving like a Nadra bull with a burr in his bit. I come to ask what has Pug of Stardock so distracted that he cannot find time to meet with his associate magicians? Has his reputation so inflated that a member of the Surani Assembly is no longer worthy of his attention?
I am sorry. Perhaps you are right. I've just been very preoccupied. I find myself obsessed with this storm. All week I've felt it building over the bitter sea, and all the while I have suspected there is more to it than it is immediately perceptible. It doesn't feel natural. Have you seen its like?
I have seen its match in destruction. As I recall, you created far more havoc in Suranui if you have disrupted my Emperor's Imperial Games. Several city blocks destroyed, countless lives lost, the Warlord cast down in dishonor.
I had a feeling you didn't summon a Riftwar to chastise me about my lack of attention. What is this about, Makala?
Your loyalties, Pug. While you claim loyalty to the Empire, you live your life under the influence of a Midkemian king and took to wife a Thuril Highlander. Your judgment is suspect.
From the day I left the Empire, my judgment and my loyalty ceased to be a concern of the Assembly of Magicians. I do what I see is best for all concerned.
I see. And is any act justifiable to that end?
If it serves the common good, yes.
Even if it violates an individual's rights?
What do you wish for me to say, Makala? You lead me as if I were one of your Nidra cows, but I'm in no mood for games. State your business.
Very well. Your daughter Gamina has blossomed into a remarkable young woman. She's beautiful, gracious, and an honor to your house. Unfortunately, she is also a girl with remarkable powers. Your love for your daughter has led you into a grievous miscarriage of your duties. Why have you let her live?
My estimations of a person's magical talents is not determined by their sex, Makala, and I refuse to murder my child to appease a barbaric tenant of the Assembly. They have no authority in Midkemia.
In this instance, I believe they will choose to ignore the geography. At this juncture, the Assembly is troubled, surrounded by anti-traditionalists who embrace your Midkemian values, led in a large part by Mara of the Akoma. A Open defiance by you as our most notable member could weaken our position within the Empire, and that is something we cannot afford. We would be forced to make you publicly comply. Although I am equally wary of female abomination, I have no desire to see your daughter dead. I have acted on your behalf and placed her in exile until such a time we can agree upon her ultimate fate. Why didn't you consult me? Where have you sent her? Seek her if you wish, but it will avail you little. Your further interference will likely ensure that the Assembly will carry out its order of death. They will be unable to kill her, however, if they cannot find her. It would be to your advantage to leave her be. I will not content myself to sit here while the Assembly banters about the value of my daughter's life. I shall find her, and then you tell your brethren to expect my visit. You embark on a dangerous road, but it is yours to take. Farewell then, Pug. The Book of Macross. Okay. Alright, is she speaking? Yes, she's speaking. Before we get this, hello folks! Welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal at Krondor, as brought to you all by Jason. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here. Welcome to the next chapter. I believe this is what, chapter 5? Chapter 6? I think chapter 6. We're getting there, folks. Anyways. The Meditation Tower being one of the first places I suspected of looking, I went there as soon as I discovered that neither he nor my daughter appeared for breakfast that morning. There I found the message that he had burnt into the wall. Book of Macross, what do you think the message means? Well, I thought for a while that he intended for us to contact the magician named Macross, but it would be a feat impossible for even Pug to accomplish. Macross led Midkemia long ago, and all he left behind were his writings. And presumably this Book of Macross would be among the books he left behind. Perhaps, but I cannot be certain. The library that Macross left on Sorcerer's Isle was vast, and it took us the better part of a year to move the bulk of it to the Academy of Stardock. Since that time, some of the volumes have been lent out to various scribes so they could be catalogued and transcribed. Well, then the book could be anywhere. New approach. Before it disappeared, did you note anything unusual that he may have said or done? As I said earlier, he had seemed agitated for some long time, but yes, there was something. About a month ago, we were walking in the gardens outside of the palace, just the two of us enjoying the day, when he suddenly halted us near a sewer grate. When I asked him what was wrong, he said, "Not all of the sheep are in our fold." Sheep? Forgive me, lady, but your husband seems to have an infuriating penchant for the cryptic. Penchant. The proper pronunciation there. Well, not ordinarily, no. Only when things are on his mind. But come, I must head towards Stardock and look for evidence of this Book of Macross there. Where shall you two go?
Yay! Gorath is back!
We go below into the sewers under Krondor, Owen. Good lady. I believe we shepherds have an errant flock of sheep to find.
Alright, so we're going to the sewers. They're starting us in the sewers. Do we still have all our shit? No, I don't want that. Let me see my gear. Oh, thank Jesus. So we still got all of our goodies. That pleases me greatly. Let's see about... Oh, come on. Seriously, you're gonna make it a pain in the ass. You're gonna make it a pain to repair my shit. Of course you are. What else would you do? There we go. All right. The dream team is reassembled. Cutscenes have been watched. I only stumbled over the words a couple times. Anyways, save because... Not because progress, but, well, you know. All right, so we're in the sewer, so it's safe to use a torch. Okay. So is this like the same? Oh my God, it even kept our map for us. Cool, all right. So I have no idea what we're looking for in here. Can we just leave? Will they let me just leave? Probably, no, seriously? Oh, it's locked, what does it take? Broken the mechanism, trying to pick it, alas. The key pick locks or otherwise. Damn. All right, well, I don't know what we're down in here for. Obviously, we're looking for probably like a thief or something, if I had to guess. There was that one dude down here that was like a friend of James's, but I have no idea where he was. Oh, that's a pit? That is a pit. Only we had a rope, alas. We are the assholes that forget to bring the damn rope. All right, that's what it is. So can I leave here? With a royal key of Krondor. We got one of those. Ha-ha! Into the palace. And we can just leave, and are we, like... All right, so we have an entrance to the sewer. Can I just go on? Oh, sweet. Shops. Oh, my God, yes. Okay. They're probably not going to buy... I was going to say, they're probably not going to buy the majority of what we have. I think these are junk now. Can we sell them? No. Oh, man. Yeah, we don't need... This is, like, poison, if I recall correctly. It's been so long... Crossbows. Alas, we do not have a Bessie Mauler on Gorath. I would be tempted. We got a bunch of stuff here. Jason has given me some hints about this chapter specifically. Notably about one side quest in particular, where I want to have a bunch of inventory space open. And we have Nightfingers. And, oh, what was the other one? This is the last chapter in the game where Gorath and Owen are really going to be able to do much shopping. So he suggested that we stock up on, you know, consumables and stuff as best we can here. So I will be looking to do that. Not necessarily here, because this is just Krondor. I really just wanted to free up some inventory space. You guys have rope. You do. Buy some rope. So that's good to know. And he also let me know that I want to end this chapter with a fair amount of food in my inventory. Different shop? Oh, it's a different shop. This is gems. Amulet of the Upright Man. Okay. Let's see, will you buy anything? Will you buy Glory Hand? No. Why won't you buy my rotting hand, you jerk? All right, back into the palace. Back into the sewer, yes. Into the reeking blackness. And we're gonna dump some stuff here because we can afford to get rid of quest items now. Get rid of this. Oh, it feels so good. I've got my spyglass and my poisoning thing. It's just, it's nice. It's nice to be back in competent feet here, I guess. Okay, so we've, again, not necessarily made progress, but we did a thing, so I'm saving it, and I guess we can start kind of poking around in here. I'm going to assume that there might be enemies floating around in here now. Even if... Let me check my map. Even if it keeps stuff cleared out from the last time we came through here, I'm fairly certain that I left some encounters. Like, I didn't clear everything. Oh, yeah, I was gonna say. Oh, man. Their opponents were surprised. The leader of the small mob screamed orders at his companions. A mix of fear and anger apparent in his voice. Oh, you guys. Oh, I missed having good characters again. Let's see, what do we got? The only downside is we don't have Evil Seek. Evil Seek was pretty nice. On the upside, though, we have Skin of the Dragon. And more importantly, we have Gorath. Oh, seriously? You paralyzed my meat shield. All right, we need to shut this dude down. Get him, Owen. Quit it. Here, let's see. I'm gonna pocket sand you. Oh, seriously? He just stunned. Yeah, I was gonna say he was... that's why I was following him around, is because I didn't want him to stun Owen, too. But alas... alas, in my effort to fight off the one that was chasing him around... things didn't end too well for Owen. That's okay. Now that I know that they have an enemy spellcaster. I didn't know that there were any rogues and spellcasters in here. Unless that's possibly a new encounter. I don't know if they're adding new ones in here. I'm sure they've added new ones to the overworld because basically every other... Oh, they were not surprised this time, alas. Every other encounter, or every other chapter, we have gotten new enemies on the overworld. You dicks with crossbows. Alright, I'm gonna try... Oh no, we're outside, we're inside, I'm an asshole. Can we... lock this guy down? No, we cannot. Crap. Alright, he got Owen. Gorath, kill him. Gorath, I think, just did, like, 500,000 points of damage there. I think I saw three numbers. Oh, Gorath, I missed you so much. Look at that. It's just like he's a walking blender. Look at that. Oh my god. It's beautiful. It is just beautiful. Is Owen poisoned? No, I'm not used to fighting bandits as opposed to Mordhall with poisoned crossbows. Another Ring of Prander, we're just gonna end up selling that. Gems, is that pocket sand? That's pocket sand, that pleases me. Spoiled rations, does he still have... Yeah, he's at 3, cool, so it didn't actually expend that one. A little bit of money and some rations. Share those out. Yeah, that was... See, like, that's all we need. Gorath could, like, basically, if it weren't for enemies that'll just lock him down with paralysis magic, I'm pretty sure Gorath could solo this whole portion of the game. Alright, we have a chest. That means... we need Scent of Sarig. I believe it is safe. Sure. What do we need? Looks complicated. All right, pick it. Gorath, you're disappointing. Let's try keys. I assume if it doesn't give the type of... Oh, broke the key. If it doesn't give the type of key... Man. If it doesn't give the type of key, I assume that like the only way to open it is pick it. That, or maybe we just don't have the type of key in our inventory, but I don't know. I'm sure someone will let me know in the comments. Oh, hey guys, I'm just here to loot your chest. It is trapped. Let's see, what's our lock picking? 16 and 27. Let's get this over with. They are not surprised. And see where it goes. So what are we facing off against here? Are those mages? I can't tell if these are magicians in the back or not. So I'm gonna move Owen up. Just in case. Some have yellow pants, others have white pants. What's the difference? I don't know. Gorath kills them all in one hit, so I don't know how much it really matters. Get him, Owen. Yeah, look at that! He hit a dude! You go, Owen. Gorath's having none of their bullshit. The temptation is to just have Owen beat the hell out of this guy. But... I think I'd much rather lock him down here. Oh my god, it has been so long. It's been so long since I've had my cheesy combat strats. Owen, you may rest. Gorath, murder. Gorath, you disappoint me. Owen, finish the job. Thank you. Alright. Now you guys can rest. You did good, so you get nap time. Jesus Christ. Gorath is just... Ah, after like trolling around with James and Locklear where like them hitting like 40s and 60s is great, going to Gorath is just like night and day. Man, I wish I had that sword that I gave to James on him. That like ridiculously powerful like Blade of War Khan or whatever the hell it was. That would be just amazing. All right. Money, more pocket sand, nice. That is incredibly pleasing to me because that stuff, I'm not gonna say it's like hilariously expensive or anything. We've got plenty of money, but I'd rather get it for free than have to pay for it. So what do we got in here? Yeah, try it. It was deactivated, nicely done. And we got some money. All right, sure, I'll take it. And we'll continue onward. I'm actually gonna save, I think. I just realized we got through a fight and nobody died, so... And we even disarmed a trap, which I'll always take considering Gorath's skill at picking locks is kind of crappy. Did he level with that by any chance? No, still 27. Curious if there's a way to actually, like, level that safely. There might be a... If I had to guess, there's probably a book or a trainer NPC or something. That seems to be kind of a, an ongoing thing. Which, like, I'm totally okay with. Don't get me wrong. Wrong button. I actually want... Is it this one? Yeah. Oh, these sewers are large and sewer-like in nature.
Oh, go there.
Oh god, a figure moved in the tunnel. Seemingly having appeared from nowhere, a young boy halted them before he could move any further ahead. I could do a Cockney accent, but I really don't want to. You're in Marker territory. I'd advise you turn about and leave before I'm forced to do to you a good bit of harm. Please, if you could just answer a few questions for us, then we'll be out of here. Questions? The only thing that concerns me is getting the mess from the storm taken care of and getting us all back on our collective feet. Ordinarily, we don't object to storm nows and then. Cleans the smell out, if you know what I mean. But this storm, it did us a piece, all right. Why, I came in from the seas and watched us squall us into the ocean. Oh, that would be a bad way to die. Destroyed our headquarters and ruined our plan to take care of a little local problem, and we almost had him. Yeah, who did you almost have? The crawler, that's who. Not that it concerns you, anyway. Once he had the upright man out of his way, I guess he decided that it was time to come around and claim his prize. We had other ideas, of course. Got a handy little trap all baited for him. One such like he couldn't refuse. Would have had him scurrying back to the Sunset Isles or wherever else in the seven lower hells he came from. Fortunately, the weather didn't cooperate with our little plan. Any of your markers magicians? No, at least none that admits it freely. Sooner cut a magician's throat than let him live among us. But if truth be known, we would have welcomed one these past few months. Some of the crawler's men are magic types. Are they? Any of them left down here? Yeah, we bumped into a group of them and they wiped my party. Who's to say? Still picking through our own dead, much less worried about which of them are still here. Large portions of the sewers are collapsed. There's even word that a portion of the seawall collapsed. Opened a new stairwell to a lower level of us. Oh, we're gonna get level 2 sewers, guys. Have you taken anything off the men who are posing as markers? Well, they're not much for carrying treasure, but yeah. I found a few nice bits. Tumbled a corpse I found near the sea gate just this morning. If price is right, I might be interested in buying the booty from you. Well then, my price is 100 gold. 100 gold? He said they didn't carry anything of value. Well, seems it's of value to you, and I say it's worth 100 sovereigns if it's worth a pence. Deal? Yeah, okay, whatever. We got money to blow. Robbery, but we'll take it. Oh, good then. I'll get my satchel for you. Alright, I guess that's it. It's time we left, Owen. Do what you like, point of ears. Just get out of the sewers before someone decides to make a meat pie out of you. Believe me, I have no burning desire to stay down here. I, for one, would be quite happy if I never see the underside of Krondor again. Goodbye, Lim, and good luck. Alright, I'm curious what we got. A note. Is that it? That looks like it. Alright, what do we got? I'm interested in your difficulties with the Guild of Thieves under Krondor. It was your responsibility to deal with them, and your special training should give you more than adequate advantage over these common thieves. You are to locate the Amulet of the Upright Man and the Idol of Lasur and load them aboard the Nightcrawler immediately. Oh, I have a feeling that's a hint. We have passing business with our serpentine clients in the Sunset Isles, and I don't believe they will be patient while I tell them about the incompetence of my hirelings. Alright, so we are looking for, apparently, the amulet. I'm gonna note this down really quick. Krondor sewers. Find amulet. The upright man and the idol of Lasur. Alright, well that's at least some important information. Works for me. So I guess we can start poking around and see if we can find these things. Alright, we have some stairs. And we have freaking Queegean pirates, seriously? Oh, the enemy jumped back. Is this seriously just like two guys? Oh my god, you dudes are so outmatched. Alright, I think 5 rounds should be more than enough here. Gorath,
Yeah. Yeah, that was a non-encounter right there. Take that, get some restoratives, 3 restoratives. Oh, not enough room. Make it fit, Owen. Oh, it's terrible. Why would I say something like that? Oh my God. All right, so we have stairs. Where do these, are these down? Looked up the narrow stairwell. Definitely a way up, but he questioned whether it was the right way for them to be going at the moment. We do not want to go up. All right, so we do find some stairs up. We are, however, looking for possibly stairs down. Somewhere. For the time being, I'm just gonna kind of like, I guess, run the perimeter and see if we can't find anything. I'm sure this is just another locked thing, so I'm not gonna bother with it. And even if not, it'll just take us like up to the palace or something. Dead end. Okay. Oh, hey. Another group. Not surprised, alas. Ah, they want us to turn around. That's a good joke. I'll have you know, gentlemen. I am capable of casting fireballs. I still wish like there was an examine command or something. What happens if you right click? All right, right clicking also attacks. Gorath, go for the dude in yellow. I don't know what he does, so I want him dead. Owen, just, I guess, defend yourself. Like, this is a non-issue of a fight here. Seriously, Gorath? Seriously? Disappointment. Owen's holding his own back there. Gorath's struggling to murder bandits. Just, I'm not mad, Gorath. I'm just disappointed. I know you're better than this. And then it's like, God, what is it? Like Record of the Lodoss Wars, where, you know, he's got like the ridiculous elf ears and they like droop when he's sad. Oh my God. You guys want fan art? Give me like, kawaii anime Gorath. And if any of you do that, I'm gonna ban you in the comments. So please don't. Nobody needs to see that. Gorath is a dignified, bearded elf. And if anyone sullies his good name, well, they're no friend of mine. Okay, oh, what is this? Nope. We have a corpse. Empty. Alas. And a chest. That is also empty. All right, the system works. Just not in our favor. Map. All right. Well, we've not done a circle. We've just come down into like a southern section of the dungeon. Well, sewers. Want to be kind of careful here so I don't accidentally throw myself off of a ledge, because I know it'll happen. All right, so I'm lost. Where were we? All right, so we met the rogue. Liam, or whatever his name is, over here. So that's an exit. I have no idea what the rest of this stuff is, so we'll poke around, I guess. I just want to take my time so I don't accidentally murder my entire party. Oh, and it's dark. I'm gonna sleep. God, Gorath, what is up with you and just hoarding my entire party's ration supply over here? Let's give Owen 5. There. Owen's a growing boy. He needs more food than Gorath does. Look at my map. Light torch. What is this? What is this? Transport through these sewers is strictly prohibited. Official kingdom business only. Swordsmaster Corby. I have no idea who that is. But I do know he's not here to stop me, and even if he were, I'm pretty sure Gorath could take him. Another chest, and more passages. Holy crap. Oh, and it was trapped. I'm an ass. All right, magical scroll, skin of the dragon. Ooh. Second skin of the dragon. All right. I don't want spoilers, but I want to get to this to my other party. I don't know where my other party is going to be in, I guess, the next time I play them, next chapter, I would assume. So this is the one time I'm gonna give you guys the okay to spoil something for me. Tell me what area of the game I need to leave this scroll of Skin of the Dragon so that I can teach it to Patris so he's capable of not dying all the time. Thank you very much. Okay, and this has connected us again with all of this. All right, so we kind of did a big circle there, but there's more areas to explore. However, we are at 32 minutes recording time, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. And I will catch you all next time, wherein the adventure continues and I start moving to stash that scroll. Until then.